We live in a life where there are three types of people. I started the series last week talking about vision, the power of vision. I'm not going to go back. I got to go forward. There are three types of people. Number one, people with no vision. A person with no vision is a man that is heading for destruction. The Bible says in Proverbs 29, where there is no vision, the people perish. A man that does not know where he's going, anywhere can take him there. And the place where he will land up is not the place he wants to be. A man with no vision will end in destruction. A man with no vision will end in confusion. When you see people that are confused, that signifies a man without a vision. Number two type of person is a man with vision. A man with vision would get to his destination. A man with vision is not confused. A man with vision is a man of purpose. A man of vision is a man going somewhere. A man of vision is a man that is empowered. A man of vision is a man that has foresight with insight. A man of vision is a man that God gives provision. When you don't have vision, God does not commit riches to your hands. Because instead of that riches to move you forward, it will destroy.
Yes.
Have you seen people that won the lottery? Have you ever watched a documentary called The Curse of the Lottery? Because money entered their hand, they had no vision. So instead of it to benefit them, it destroyed them.
Yes.
A man that prays for riches without vision is a man that is asking for death before his time. So you must be a man of vision, because God is a God of vision. The NIV says, when there's no vision, the people cast off restraint. They cast off restraint. The Bible says in the scripture concerning the children of Israel, when Moses went up to the mountain, the Bible says, and he left them in the hands of a priest called Aaron. Aaron was a man of no vision. The Bible says by the time Moses was coming down, the people went wild. The Bible says Aaron said, I didn't know what else to do. So I asked them to give me their gold. And they gave me their gold. Here is Makile, brother. They gave him their gold. Listen, these were all the gold that God used to repay them for the labor of 400 years. When God paid them back after they stayed in Egypt for 430 years, God told them, I'm going to cause Egyptians to be favorably disposed towards you. And the Bible said that night, by the time they left, in one day, God repaid them the labor for over 400 years. Hear this. So what happened that day, why it was so important, and that made Aaron to lose the kingship, the priesthood. From that day, nobody ever heard of Aaron anymore. Because he told the children of Israel, give me that gold. He said, I took the gold, I threw it into fire, and out came the calf. So what that simply means was, a priest without a vision destroyed God's reward for over 400 years. Tell me God is not upset.
Right.
That's how you can provoke God, that God can demand. You know what? God visited anger upon the children of Israel, that even they began to kill themselves. He had to tell the Levites, kill, and who's on the Lord's side? Some of them were not on the Lord's side because of one man that lost vision. Do you know some families are in problem today because a father had no vision? A mother lost the vision, and all of a sudden the children went wild. It takes only one mistake to destroy good inheritances of generations. I'm coming there. No vision. Tell your neighbor, may you not be a person of no vision.